Strong enough to come God for my sister, my twin. She drove me to the church, and I was just joking, Bishop. I said, oh, man, I'm in church. I feel like dancing. And I knew that wasn't going to happen because it was impossible. I thought I was too weak and too sickly and too frail, but I sat in that service. And all the saints was just going in and out of time. And I sat there just weeping in my spirit because I couldn't even move compared to sick.
Yes,
Bishop finished preaching. At the end of this message, Bishop, you said, stand up and tell three people, I'm still here. Like what happened, she was crying, hoisted myself up, went to one person real close, and I was going to stop and go. I'm still here. Something in it, said, go a little further. So I walked a little further and found somebody else in the church I don't really talk to. And said, I'm still here. And I said, well, two out of three, I might as well hit the last one.
Yes.
Went a little further, and I think it was my aunt died. This is missionary times, and I saw her walk in. And I said, I'm still here. And you know how we old saints of God, we wait for the tingle, and he from my side come in right then. That's all right. Bishop, I started walking back to my seat. Something down in my head. Hey, God, started to run. And when I got back to my seat, I threw up on my I'm gonna make you mine.
Thank you.
I know what it's like to be in pain for 4 months and have to have help. I'm glad for you, brother. We want to dedicate this song to you. Jesus will. Brother C.I. Amen. And Bishop Brown, God bless you all on this afternoon. Jesus, he will. Hallelujah.
Thank you. how to worship us, or bring me an offering. And so tonight we want to offer to the Lord an offering that is pleasing in His sight, that is appropriate for the blessings that He has bestowed upon our life. The Bible declares, give and it shall be given back unto you. Good measure, pressed down, shaken together, and running over, men will give into your bosom with the same expectation in which you release your seed. That is the same expectation in which the Lord will release back unto you. How many of you in here can stand some overflow in your life? Who desires a little overflow, our lives. Now you know exactly what area, what aspect, what component of your life overflow is needed. You know, no one knows like you know where overflow is needed. And so tonight I don't want us to give just because we're asked to give, but I really want us to give with purpose. I want us to purpose in our hearts that first we're going to give God our very best. Then secondly, we're going to give this seed as a release for our overflow. Now tonight I'm going to begin the offering with $50 and my vice president. And all of my executive staff are going to give $30 tonight, and they're moving even as I'm speaking. And I ask those of you here in the house of the Lord tonight that you would give at least a $20 seed in your hand, that you would give at least a $20 offering in your hand. We certainly want the Lord to bless us. We want the Lord to be, we want the Lord to bless this convention. We want the Lord to bless this convention spiritually. We want to be a blessing to this convention naturally. We thank God for the opportunity to have this music before the opportunity for the saints to come together and exercise their gifts in the areas of music ministry and arts, as well as the spoken word. This is an opportunity our bishop, board of superintendents, continuously to afford to us so that everyone has a part in each and every convention that we have. So at this time, amen. Will there be anyone else that will join me? Thank you, Lord Townsend, for your offering. Amen. We praise the Lord for Superintendent Vincent. God bless you. Pastor Baker. Amen. God bless you, Superintendent Vincent. I'm going to give 100 tonight. Pastor McMurray is going to give 50. Our bishop is giving all the saints of God our 50. Yes, if you have capability for debit card transactions, we'll be here to our left and your right. Let's stand to our feet. 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 Amen. Congratulations. Amen. Praise the Lord. Two feet. Stand.
Yes, thank you, Lord.
Amen. As the young people sitting down, I really want to understand why. Amen. You're not going to be able to get up, so jump up while you're able to.
Amen.
Jump up while you're able to. That's what you're going to be able to do. Jump up, jump up. God bless you. God bless you. Amen. We thank the Lord for each and every one of you tonight. I want you to put a smile on your face. The Bible declares that He loves a cheerful giver. He loves a jubilant giver. Amen. God bless our bishop. God bless you. Thank you, bishop. God bless you for your offering. The Bible declares that He loves a cheerful giver. He loves a cheerful giver. The Bible also says that a liberal soul, the soul that gives liberally, would be made fat. In other words, the soul that gives liberally will make room for increase to take place in their lives. And so today, as we're decreeing and declaring the overflow of God is released over our lives, we are preparing ourselves to receive the increase of God. We've got to get your release. So let's prepare ourselves to give. Father, we thank you and we praise you for the substance in which you have blessed us with to release to this convention, which is fertile ground. We thank you in advance for what is taking root in the realm of the Spirit and what you are allowing to grow forth and to germinate and to pollinate in our lives. We thank you for overflow. We thank you for increase. We thank you for you are Jehovah Jireh. You are the God who provides. And so, Lord, as we give cheerfully. We give with expectation that there will be no lack in our lives. We thank you that as we give, Lord, that every need will be met. And you are perfecting everything that concerneth us. In the name of the Lord Jesus, who is the Christ, amen, amen. At this time, please be guided by these wonderful, gracious sanctuary servants. Let's come, giving, smiling unto the Lord tonight. Thank you. desire to ensure that we have the opportunity to honor seniors and troubled pioneers who have paved the way to this jurisdiction, maybe not necessarily the jurisdiction, but in their local churches and in their community. So on this Friday at 11 a.m., we're going to be honoring you trailblazers from our jurisdiction. We're trying to get to every church, as many people as we can, because we can't do more than a few at a time, because we make a really long program. But this year, we want you to come out and support. If you're not busy during the daytime, Friday at 11 a.m., we're going to be honoring Brother Jesse Shannon of the Shoeline Community Church of God in Christ. We'll be honoring Pastor Sammy Jones of Harvestline Church of God in Christ. We'll be honoring Missionary Ruby Jenkins. We'll be honoring Superintendent Levi Bell. Come out and be a part of that. Okay, amen. Yes. And also, Deacon Thomas from the Altar of Glory Church of God in Christ. And so, after we finish honoring these wonderful pioneers, these trailblazers, we have our jurisdiction is hosting a free luncheon. And so, if you plan to attend, you can see me so that we can get a good count for all of you, ensure that we have enough food to serve you and to provide the hospitality that you desire, that our bishop desires to extend to you with the spirit of excellence. God bless you at this time. Be back in the hands of our wonderful MC. Let's praise the Lord for Elder Sam Thomas. We have the light of God, healing, power of God that is taking you through this life. Come on, can we praise the Lord? Can we praise the Lord? We are excited about what God is doing. We will let the Lord get on for this year.
Thank you, Pastor Johnson. Well, we ready to go a little higher?
Amen.
Y'all have a good day. Who ready on this side to go a little higher?
Thank you.
before he said, are you saved? Ooh. And I knew good luck with my offering money in my pocket. I knew I was too young dumb to learn service. I knew I lived in my mama's pocketbook in the back seat while I was riding home. But I knew the question was coming, mother. And so I had to get right before I got to the front door. Turn and say, neighbor, are you
our inspirational speaker on tonight, Pastor Andre Winston.
Amen.
It's a double blessing, not just because he is a powerful, anointed, consecrated man of God, but because he's my little brother. Oh, yes, he is. I have to admit, he found the fire before I did, and I like that too much. He learned how to play the organ before I did, and I like that too much. He learned how to preach and hoop like daddy before I did, and I like that too much. But Bishop, I felt better when he started going to greater glory, and he just started playing the organ. I felt I was a little, you know, I'm older and I'm sitting in the pool, but he got me stuck to the organ. So I said, hallelujah, thank God, let him humble you. And the next thing I know, God, I'm calling him a pastor. And I am so excited for my brother. Leading lost souls to Christ and bringing souls to the kingdom. So after this election by the Blessed Temple Church of God in Christ Choir, I want to ask everyone to stand to your feet in reverence for the man of God who brings the word of God, Pastor Andre Winston. Amen.
Amen. If God is good to you, when you truly love him, come on, just open up your mouth and worship him. Come on, open up your mouth and bless him. Come on, say something sweet. God, you're amazing. God, you are wonderful. God, you've been good. Hallelujah, Jesus. My whole heart, and I'm a blessed.
second chronicle is found after first chronicle.
Good books up.
And as you turn it there, first give honor to God who's the help of my life. Certainly give honor to our illustrious bishop. Amen. Bishop Leo C. Brown Jr. Let's go on and praise. Amen. Amen for our leader. Amen to his lovely wife, Dr. Patricia Brown. And certainly thank God for you. Amen to the angel of this house. Amen. Superintendent Vincent. Amen. I know he's stepping out of time for business. Amen to his lovely wife. Amen. To our jurisdictional, amen, music department, amen, president, amen. Pastor Snyder Johnson, for many years have served this church faithfully, amen, to assist, amen, her please assist, amen, my cousin, amen, Sister Cobbs, amen, we thank God for her, amen, to Washington Northwest Ecclesiastical Jurisdiction, amen, Bishop Harvey, president, amen, and Elder Johnny, amen, Murray, we thank God for you. Amen to my brother, amen. I texted him a few months ago and I said, you're some kind of brother. You're just some kind of brother. Appreciate you. Amen. And I thank God for you, amen. I've never been introduced like that. Amen. I was just up here to love you, amen. Amen. Praise God, amen. And to all these great backdoctrinal preachers, amen. And to, amen, my superintendent, amen. The greatest superintendent, amen. On this side of the earth, amen. Superintendent Larry Carter. Amen. And to a very special lady in my life. Amen. I see something called her beautiful.
Yes.
Oh, yeah. God bless you. Amen. To the blessed temple family. God bless you. Music department, amen. God bless you to all my great pastors who I know is praying for me. Amen. I promise you all. Amen. But to all the administrative assistants, amen, in their absence, amen. For those of you that are here, God bless you, amen. You ready for a word? Touch your hands, I'm ready for a word. I promise you all, you're going to be long, but just shout to somebody and say, I'm ready for a word. Second Chronicles 20:22 says, and when they began to sing and praise, let me say that again, and when they began to sing and praise, the Lord, somebody shout the Lord, Lord, that sounds good, that sounds, somebody shout the Lord. Elder Townsend, I think that side is praising the Lord, they're talking about it. Somebody one more time shout, the Lord! Set ambushments against the children of Ammon, Moab, and Mount Seir, which were come against Judah.
When the preacher died,
then praise you. Look at your neighbor and say, something's always happening to you. Come on, look at your neighbor and talk to your neighbor and say, neighbor, something always again. Because your praise and your God is ready to revive in us this week. Amen. You are never going to see that enemy again. Touch your neighbor and say, neighbor, nothing can stop me. Because I'm all the way up. Stop me. Because I'm all the way up. I have to give God praise.
it and say they've either been through some things. Come on, we'll look at somebody else and say, maybe the enemy tried to stop some things, but he was not able to stop those things because I'm a praiser. Understand me, believers, because the real sign of a true praiser is this.
What is it?
Your praise will always affect your situation. Your situation will never affect your praise. Oh, I know some of y'all missed it. But I come to tell you that your praise has the ability to affect your situation. Yes. And the real sign of a true praiser is they never allow their situation, are you with me, church, to affect their praise. Yes. That's why the Son of David said, he said, somewhere around there. Amen. They told the man. for physical needs. But when he heard that Jesus was here, he stopped asking people for stuff. He asked Jesus for a miracle. Look at your neighbor and say, this week, I don't need nothing from you. Come on, this week, I don't need a new pair of shoes. Hello, somebody. This week, I don't need some new glasses. This week, surrounding them. And they have them cornered and trapped. And they're praising God the best way they can. They're faithful to God the best that they can. But somehow the enemy is closing in on them. But you ought to encourage your neighbor next to you and say, neighbor, this week you don't have to worry. Because God is getting ready to release you. God is getting ready to set you free. Sword in my enemy. destroy its own self. Well, all you got to do is praise God. Do I got any praises in here that you walk into service, being surrounded by your enemy, and all of a sudden you gave God one more chance of praise? You gave God one more glory, hallelujah. You gave God one more thank you, Jesus. You begin to run and pick him up and put him down. And by the time you got home, that whole situation was turned all the way around. I believe that this week, some of the things I've got in my life, that I will praise God every day. I will shout every day. I will glorify God every day. And because I believe that God is going to hear my praise and come and see about my needs. Let me hear F sharp, because that's a little culture. Believers, to bring the foot pedal, put it on the floor.
Yeah. Ah!
Brown. We must hear from him. He's just going to wave. Just wave high, Bishop. Wave with high. Let's keep in our prayers. Yes. Amen. Yes. Amen. Father, remarks. Administrative assistant. He's saying no. Wave high. Wave high at us. Yes. Amen. Let's say amen from our president.
God bless you. Everybody's quiet tonight. Amen. But we want to remind you.
Don't worry. Nobody will lose this week.
Tuesday morning at 10 a.m. Tuesday morning at 10 a.m. Please make it your business, make it your purpose to come out and be a support of this great, great convention. Let's stand to our feet. Let's stand to our feet.
Church this week,
praise God for Elder Sam Townsend. Oh, let's one more time, Pastor Andre Winston.
Now we thank you for your time tonight. We thank you, Lord. Ears have heard and eyes have seen. We thank you, Lord, because we believe that even on this week that miracles will
come to pass.
We pray, God, that we
church this week.
Certainly not for this
year. We pray, God, this week
that God, you would have us to come back with great expectation. We pray for the leader of this jurisdiction. Bishop Brown, that you would give him strength.
Fill it up.
Oh God, that you would give him vision to cast even the more. We pray for his wife, Dr. Brown, Patricia Brown, that you would give her, oh God, the wisdom how to encourage him and how to lift him up. Oh God, in the name of Jesus, bless the pastors. Bless all the leaders, God. Bless the presidents of this music department, everyone. Oh God, under the sound of my voice, God, and as again I say, as we leave your this place, but certainly not from your presence, that you would bring us back at the appointed time without the loss of one. These and all other blessings we ask in your Son Jesus' name we pray. And all the people of God that believe the report of the Lord said, amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. And as my bishop would say, as I say unto one.